Next, akarma means not karma, doing inaction. It is not in action, it is inaction, one word. Or non-performance, just sit idle physically. Psychologically, if one can sit idle without any dualities of do's and don'ts, good and bad, that is superb. But physically sitting idle and thinking of n number of things and thousand and one things is not accepted. We should be very, very clear. Now again, if you see in the next layer, you know, these words have different meanings in different layers. So if you say karma, just the word karma, as we have seen vihita karma earlier, a few seconds back, that says ordinary actions and daily duties of life. Ordinary actions of daily duties of life, they have to be performed at any given point. Shauchaha, for example, to start with, cleanliness, tidiness. The moment you get up in the morning, just rub your palms and chant Karagre Usre Lakshmi and turn towards your right slowly, Bhusparsha, and then slowly get down, brush your teeth, right? Whatever it is. Right from there it's done. Students, daily you have to study, even if it is a Sunday or a holiday, Christmas vacations. Yes, schools are closed for Christmas vacations or for anything or for Makara Sankranti, but study, you have to study as a student daily, or else you get lost, the touch is lost. Daily you have to study, minimum 2 hours. So in fact, what I feel is on holidays you study more because you have more time, you are not going to school, you are at home, you have more time, spend more productively, gaining more knowledge. Knowledge is power, as it is said. Oh, today is Sunday, no school, no online classes, I'll get up at 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. No. Sunday or Monday, rain or shine, before the sun rise, you are up in the bed. Very clear. Before the sun rises, you are supposed to get up and welcome the sun with Surya Namaskar. That's very, very important. Night I may sleep at 1 o'clock, no problem. Yes, but you are supposed to get up at, based on the time, you know, summers, the sun rises a bit early, 5:30, 45, winters, the sun rises late, 6, 6:15, 6:30, yes. Based on that timing, before that you are supposed to get up. If not bath, you know, at least fresh up and do Surya Namaskar. In winter season, therefore it is said that before the sun rises, you are supposed to get up. It's only to shrug off laziness. You are supposed to get up, have your shower and do Nakshatra Darshana. You are supposed to see the stars and worship the luminous bodies. In winter, generally in winter we have a rasa or a rug and we try to lie down for a longer time. No, that is not the way. Therefore, in Dhanurmasa, they say Thirupavu is read early in the morning. At the time of sunrise, you should have got up, you should have prepared your prasadam also and kept for nevejyam. At the time of sunrise, the nevejyam should be ready. Just imagine. So night itself, before going to bed, clean the puja room, keep all the vessels, photos, videos and all clean. Right? Morning, get up, have your shower, come to the puja. Do all the decorations, do the puja gija and all, and cook in the pure form, you know, physically, that is, we call as muddy in our colloquial regional language. Having taken bath, you know, wear fresh washed clothes which are not touched by anybody, so it is not contaminated. Nowadays, we are following that corona, you know, the moment you come, you just put your dress out, you wash, and then you keep safe. Right? Similarly, every day, Dhanurmasa every day, 6:30 prasadam should be done. Do pongal and keep sweet pongal or kesari or anything. And see the magic. How would it be? That is karma, daily duty. Abba, today is Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. 2 days if you go to office. 2 days holidays. Why that? Enjoy your work. Karma, your daily duties have to be performed with joy. Vikarma. So doing the same work without personal attachment and in the spirit of dedication to the God. So earlier we said Vikarma is Nishiddha Karma, work that are not to be done. Now here what we are saying is the second meaning, in the second layer, we are doing our duty without personal attachment. And in the spirit of dedication, Krishna Arpanamastu, Brahma Arpanamastu, Rama Arpanamastu, Shiva Arpanamastu, means offering it. That is Vikarma. The third one is Akarma, the other meaning, state of purity and complete absorption in the self. Earlier Akarma we have seen idleness, non-performing and just sitting idle. Correct? Lazy people. Now the other inner meaning of that is state of purity in the mind and in the heart. And total absorption in the self. You are sitting, just sit and you are enjoying. You are not feeling bored. You are not thinking about something. You are not scheming something. You are not planning something. You are just sitting absorbed into your own self and enjoying. These are the three types of karmas that we are supposed to understand. We will see things further in the upcoming sessions. So now, as we have seen, just fall into the third one, that is Akarma's second meaning, absorbing into, getting absorbed into the self. Just stay put there for as long as possible, as long as you feel comfortable. Right? With this, we'll conclude today's session. Thanks for being with me. Krishnam Vande Jagat Guru.